Okay, we've had a lot of odd winds lately. I know it's fall and all, but it just seems, like I said, certain times it doesn't seem normal, but regardless, going to put a mixture of sunflowers all the way around the garden, like I said I was going to, this next spring. And I'm going to plant them in March, and then about end of April I'll plant others. I'm not going to plant them real tight because I'm going to be planting them a month and a half later. Start around the first week of March. And then I'd say about 3 weeks later I'll plant some. And 3 weeks after that I'll plant some. And 3 weeks after that I'll plant some. So you can see it's going to go all the way around the garden. This is going to be a lot bigger than it was this year with just that one grouping. I've got everything tore up except for two purple hull peas over there. Those are seeds that I actually just dropped when they were freshly picked. And I wasn't going to plant them, but they fell. And I figured, well, okay, I just went ahead and put them down there. And they grew up, and I've already got about 12 or 18 pods off each one. It's not a lot, but it was something. I pulled up the black-eyed peas. I have one honeydew melon that I covered because I want to see how far it'll go here. It might go out another 2 weeks, 3 weeks. I don't know if it'll get much bigger, though. Hopefully it will. So that one just started, and I thought, cool. These are all just coming out on their own, and I'm not discouraging them. But see this bean here, I don't even know which kind of bean this is, but it's growing really good, so I'm going to let this keep going. That one there too, it was dying off and now it's growing again. The okra, we're going to be cutting this down. Today's the first of October. This weekend, second and third, we'll cut down about 80% of this, I'd say. And just stack them, you know, big to small, to go around the front garden. Because this plastic's going to be pulled back halfway, at least to here. After I'm going to have to cut those off with a saw. And it's like little tree trunks, you know. So, and then I got peanuts over there. Oh, I just realized that I can't pull it back over there. Jesus. Well, crap, that really messes me up now. I gotta wait till like end of October. Anyway, got these purple pole beans here growing. Every once in a while they'll get like this. I'll get like about 20 or 30 of them at a time, and then they'll go, like they're not growing anything, then they pop out again. The tomatoes are coming out really, really good. This is the plant I put out here. Look at that thing. These are the two we put out here. This one was all brown spot. Earlier videos, you can even see I've cut off so many branches on the thing and let this one, look at it, there's two big tomatoes on that still. And this other one too. Oh, I want to show you. This is the best friend a gardener could have, is a wasp. Those horn ones we got. Look at that one right there. Where's that? Let me see if I can get on the viewfinder. Right there, see all those little white things? Those are parasites, those are eggs from a wasp on the backs of that hornworm. If I can get it out of here. See that hornworm right there? He's dead pretty much now. He's like being eaten up by all those parasites, all those eggs killing our plants. Those parasites will not hurt our tomato plants. It's killing that damn hornworm though, thank goodness. I wish they'd do that earlier in the summer. One or two I think I've seen, but it was, no, I take it back. It was about 2 or 3 weeks ago I seen one. And that one there is the second one. I've read how they do that, but look, I said, look at this. This is the first day of October, and these tomato plants, look at the flowers on them. And we had a couple butterflies out here, and the only problem is the bees. We got flowers on this bean plant right down there, and torch sunflower is still growing. This one fell over. I'm gonna cut that one off right there. The main stem, and use all those heads for seeds, man. So we'll have, like I said, torch and Titan and mammoth sunflowers all the way around mixed together. And I'm gonna plant two, three, four, five, like that all the way around. And then 3 weeks later, do the same thing. And then 3 weeks later, the same thing. At least three times. I might do it a fourth time. And then they'll just constantly be coming up. Over here by the house, I was gonna do more. I'm gonna put that brick, I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller over here. I'm gonna take up the plastic and till over there, put those bricks around there so it'll be a little bit smaller, neater. And then I'm gonna see these torch here I planted about a month ago. And you see they come out here, I've had hummingbirds already over here. the butterflies and the bees in the spring and summer will be over on these all the time around the fireplace here, and we can sit out our window. I had some planted right in front of the window too, so I'm gonna try to do that again this spring. That one, see, I have it in between the windows here and between windows here, but look how small this side right here gets. A lot of shade, not too much grows over here. Sunflower, the hummingbird vines do, but that's torch sunflower right there and those over there. So it'll look really nice. Attract a lot of butterflies, bees, and like I say, in a couple days I might go ahead and tear up those other two purple hull peas in that second number three garden back there and fold it up to about where that pot is upside down. What is that? Fold it up to, oh, wrong one. Up to about where that one is in the back garden there, and fill all that up. So that'll be done until spring. October 1st, 2015. And I don't have the time right now. It's about 3:30-ish. So this full moon was right there, but then those clouds, it was amazing how all of a sudden all those clouds just kept coming in and it completely covered the eclipse. So there you go.